Hello students of class 7th standard. Today we will continue the same chapter, the energy. Okay, so here we will today discuss the same part, that interconversion of energy. So kinetic to potential energy, that I have already told you. So just I'm just reminding you that one, while you will just convert this one, kinetic energy to potential energy and the potential energy to the kinetic energy in a same example, in a one example, then you can straight away write the simple pendulum. If you talk about the simple pendulum, then in this particular device you can get the two things in a consecutive way. Okay, kinetic energy will be converted to the potential energy, and potential energy will also be converted to the kinetic energy. I will not take so many time. I'm just telling in a brief that how it works. Okay, suppose you know that one, the simple pendulum, you have already learned that one. So one thread is there, on one string is there, one bob is there having mass m amount. Now it is continuously just oscillating, or it is just moving in this way. We all know that how the simple pendulum works in this way. So this is the mass m here and the mass m here. So this will be slightly bigger because this portion, and where it will go upward. So this is maybe the base portion. Okay, this is the ground. Okay, now if you talk about the mass, if you talk about the position of the simple pendulum, suppose I am just telling you three positions, A, B and C positions, you can easily see that one, the height of this mass from here, from the ground, is actually less. Height of the bob from here is more, here also more. Okay, in this portion, or you can tell in other way also, while the simple pendulum will go to the extreme point, it will come to the rest position. When it will come to this position, the potential, so when it will go to the extreme position, what will be the maximum amount of energy, potential energy, will get here in this portion. While it will come back to this position, then definitely kinetic energy will arise, potential energy will be converted to the zero position, zero. And again, when it will go to the C position, then again the kinetic energy will be converted to the potential energy. In other way, you can also tell that one, while the height is more, definitely mgh will be more. Okay, because potential energy is definitely depends on the height. When height is less, potential energy is less. At that position, kinetic energy will be more. In this position, again the height will be more, so definitely the mgh, this amount will be more. So here in this position, potential energy is more. In A position and C position and B position, you will get the kinetic energy is more here. So this is the conversion. Okay, while it is here, put more potential energy, while it will come down, more kinetic energy, while it will go to the again extreme position, again more potential energy. So this is the example of a kinetic to potential in a different form. Okay, next one, you will come to the, in this way you can just convert so many types of energy in one form to the other forms. Next example from your book, or I'm just telling you a few examples, electrical to the sound energy. Okay, so while you will talk about the, I'm just telling you a few examples, electrical to sound energy. Okay, so while you talk about the electrical energy to the sound energy, definitely you have to tell one example, that is called loudspeaker. While you talk about the loudspeaker, then you know that one, in loudspeaker, what type of thing is happening? Continuously vibration is happening. From where the vibration is coming? Because of the electrical supply. Mic is there. On that mic, electrical wire is connected, from where electrical energy is passing and which is coming to the speaker. Speaker vibrates and it creates the sound energy. So you can easily tell that one, electrical energy can be converted to the sound energy with the help of loudspeaker, any type of speakers. Okay, mobile phone speaker, you can tell the loudspeaker of mic, you can tell the loudspeaker of amplifier, anywhere this type of conversion happens. Next one, if you talk about the opposite of that one, just the reverse, if you talk about that sound to electrical, if you talk about, then you can give the example of two things. First of all, you can give the example of microphone. Okay, suppose you know that one, microphone, that wireless, not wireless, I'm not telling, the wired microphone, through which when we are just talking something, what is happening in that one? Suppose this is the microphone, here we are just telling something, sound energy, while you will talk something, then definitely sound energy will enter, through which one wire is connected, and here one speaker is connected. This is speaker. So through this wire, okay, sound energy will not able to pass. That is for your information. While you will talk about something, then sound energy will be created. That sound energy here, with the help of the microphone, with the help of the microphone, this one will be converted to the electrical energy. And through this wire, electrical energy will pass. And this electrical energy can be converted to the sound energy again with the help of speaker that we have already discussed, electrical to sound. So electrical will pass through the wire. That electrical energy will be converted to the sound energy with the help of speaker. Okay, so microphone is a device. Here we can only get that sound energy is converted to the electrical energy. Okay, so this microphone is a device. Transducer is also one type of device which can able to convert the same thing. Okay, with the help of the electromagnetic induction theory, you can easily get this type of thing that you will read in the higher classes. So you just remember this one. Okay, this is the microphone. Next one is the electrical to heat energy. Okay, suppose you are talking about the electrical energy to the heat energy, then you can easily tell the example of electrical heater. You can tell the electrical example of electrical iron. So electrical to heat energy. Okay, so this is one example. So here you can tell the electrical heater. Okay, we all know that the electrical iron, you can also tell. These all are the example of the conversion of electrical energy to the heat energy. We all know that heater, how it works. We all have seen that type of thing. In heater, what type of thing? So many coils are present. Okay, this type of coils are present. Now this one, while it will connect to the electrical supply, that electricity when it will pass through this one. Okay, then what will happen in this way? Then these all coils are getting warmer and warmer. Okay, they are just actually giving the huge amount of heat energy to the outside. So if you just want to cook something with the help of utensils, you can easily just do the same, because in this case electrical energy will be converted to the heat energy with the help of electrical heater. Iron, we have already seen that one. If you want to press something or any clothes, then definitely with the help of iron that can be done. With this also example of the electrical energy to the heat energy, we all know that. Next example is heat energy to the opposite one. Just I am telling that heat energy to the electrical energy. Suppose you are talking that heat to electrical. Heat to electrical, one example, just try to remember that one, TEG. Okay, TEG means thermoelectrical generator. That means thermoelectrical generators. Okay, thermoelectrical generator is one type of device which can easily convert that heat energy to the electrical energy. With the help of the heat supply, with the help of heat energy, we can able to produce the electricity with the help of TGE. Okay, so thermo means heat, electrical means electrical, you know that one, and generator is a device. So it is a generator. Operating system or the working principle I am not telling you, it's a very long process. Just I am telling you the name of that one, so try to remember that one. Next example is the mechanical energy to the sound energy. Mechanical to sound. Okay, mechanical to sound, if you talk about, then just rub your hand like that. Okay, or just clap your hand like that, not rubbing, just clapping of that one. So if you clap your hand, then you are doing some mechanical things. So with this mechanical thing, you are just producing the sound energy, so you can hear the sound of that one. Okay, so this type of thing is a mechanical to sound energy. Next example is the that light to heat energy, that means very important that one. So we can easily tell that one, light to heat. So light energy to heat energy, when we will talk about, then definitely we just we can tell that the incandescent lights or the bulb. Okay, so bulb, if you talk about, we all know that this type of thing is present. Some incandescents we are talking about, not we are talking about the LED bulbs. Okay, this type of device is present. So here we can see that when the electricity will come to this one, this is known as the filament, we all know that. So when the electricity will come to that one, this particular thing, this filament will try to glow. Actually this heat will just catch up here and the huge amount of heat energy will be created. So you can also tell that one, that electrical energy to light energy, same example you can tell that one. From here, if you touch the bulb outside, then you can feel the heat of that one. So heat energy is basically generating with the help of light, because light is produces here. So this is the thing here. Next one is the light to electrical energy. Light energy to electrical energy, suppose if you talk about, then basic example is photoelectric cell or photocell, you can tell. Okay, so light energy to electrical, this is very important and repeatedly asked in the exam, this example. So you can write down that photocell or photoelectric cell, you can tell that one. Photoelectric cell, we have already seen this type of solar panels are there. So many solar panels, maybe you have seen. Yes, so many boxes are there. In these boxes, when the light energy from sun is just fallen here in this way, then what will happen from here? Electron supply will be created. That means current will be generated from here. So I current can be produced with the help of sunlight. Okay, so this is the light energy to electrical energy. Next example is the electrical to chemical energy. Okay, electrical to chemical energy. Electrical to chemical energy, suppose if you talk about, then you have to tell the electrolysis process. Okay, electrolysis process is one type of process, you will learn that one in higher classes. In this particular process, what we are doing, one container is there, two electrodes, that means cathodes and anodes are there, and here we will connect these cathodes and anodes with the help of with the battery. Here so many chemicals are there, and in this, through which what will happen, when the electrical supply will come, then these chemical will just try to just react, or they will just break into two parts. So with the help of the electrical energy, we are just getting the chemical reactions. So this is the electrical energy to chemical energy. Next one, if you talk about the opposite of that one, last part I am telling you, chemical to electrical energy, then simple example, battery. Okay, when the chemicals are present already, and due to that chemicals, we are getting the electrical supply from the battery. This is our DC current, you can also tell direct current. So these all are the examples. So try to remember, try to read that one. Thank you.